Thank you. To the audience here in the Théâtre de Beaulieu, to our viewers on the web and on Arte Concert, welcome to the 43rd Prix de Lausanne. This is the 43rd year of a competition which for 1 week every year since 1973 has put Lausanne at the center of the international dance community and launched the careers of some of the world's greatest ballet stars. The Prix's aim now, as always, is to support talented young dancers aged between 15 and 19 as they prepare for an international career. And it does this by opening the doors of some of the world's best ballet schools and companies. My name's Deborah Bull, and I'm one of those dancers who had the life-changing experience of winning a prize here in Lausanne. But today, I'm delighted to be your host for the 2015 competition. So this year, thank you. This year, 300 dancers applied to come to Lausanne. For the 70 who were selected, the competition began last Sunday when they arrived here for the selection rounds. Over the course of the week, they've been seen by the jury in ballet classes, contemporary classes, in coaching sessions in the studio and here on the stage in their two variations. Of that original 70, 20 have been selected to take part in the finals today. So today the jury will evaluate each one of those candidates in two variations. And first of all, we're going to see them perform a solo from the classical repertoire. So without further ado, we wish them all the very best of luck, and we hope that you enjoy the 2015 Prix de Lausanne.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And so now we move on to the second part of today's final, when you'll see each candidate perform a contemporary ballet variation. The Prix de Lausanne includes contemporary as well as classical ballet because dancers today have to be more versatile than ever before. The variations you're about to see are just an indication of the wide range of styles that they'll be expected to master during a professional career. The Prix de Lausanne is very grateful to our three choreographers, Louise Deleur, Goya Montero and Richard Werlock, who've generously contributed their work to the Prix de Lausanne. So we hope you enjoy watching today's finalists performing these contemporary ballet variations.
Thank you.
So that was our final candidate in the 2015 Prix de Lausanne. The jury's marks will now be handed to our computer experts, and they will calculate this year's winners. For our interlude performance today, we're delighted to welcome some dancers from one of the Prix de Lausanne's partner companies, the Queensland Ballet's Jette Parker Young Artists Programme. And they're going to dance Glass Concerto, which has been specially choreographed for today's event. After that, we welcome back three former Prix de Lausanne winners from the Armenian company Forceful Feelings. They're going to dance a piece called Serenity. And after that, the president of the jury will announce this year's winners. That's all after an intermission of 30 minutes, but it's your chance now to take part in today's final by voting for your favorite amongst the candidates today. And you can do that in two ways. If you have a Swiss mobile phone, send an SMS to the number 939, quoting the letters P, D, L, and the number of your favorite candidate. And of course, you can also vote via the Prix de Lausanne website, www.prixdelausanne.org. So please do join in, register your vote, and we'll look forward to seeing you again after a 30-minute intermission. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you and welcome back to the Théâtre de Beaulieu, where in about 40 minutes' time, we'll find out which of today's candidates will take home prizes in the 43rd year of the Prix de Lausanne. But first of all, we have a special interlude performance for you to enjoy. We're delighted to be able to present dancers from one of the Prix de Lausanne's partner companies, the Queensland Ballet's Jette Parker Young Artists Programme. They're going to dance Glass Concerto, and it's been specially choreographed for today's event by Greg Horseman. Following that, we welcome back three former winners of the Prix de Lausanne, Karen Azatian, Arsen Mirabian, and Vahe Martirossian. They're from the Armenian company, Forceful Feelings, and they're going to dance Serenity, choreographed by Arsen Mirabian. So, please give a warm welcome to these talented young performers and enjoy this interlude performance. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
you. Well, that was an exceptional interlude performance. Thank you to the dancers of Forceful Feelings and, of course, to the Queensland Ballet's Yetta Parker Young Artist Programme. And I'm delighted, in this few moments before we announce the winners of this year's competition, to be joined here on the stage by two very good friends of the Prix de Lausanne, Lee Kunjin, who is the Artistic Director of the Queensland Ballet, and Greg Horseman. So, Lee, let me start with you. We've seen a fantastic celebration of young talent, and I know that your Yetta Parker Young Artist Programme is really helping dancers transition from training to a professional life. What are the challenges that they face, and how does your programme help them to overcome those challenges?
You're right. I agree that there are many wonderful, exciting young ballet talents emerging each year. But the major challenge I see that's facing them today, it is to find a suitable home at the end of their training. Ever since the global financial crisis, the jobs opportunity in the ballet world seems to be shrinking rather than expanding. So that makes the program such as our Yetta Parker Young Artists that much more important. It's all because of the incredible generosity of Yetta and Alan Parker and their Oak Foundation, which is also one of the major sponsors of the Prix de Lausanne. And this program allows us to have 8 young artists each year. And they work with the company, they perform with the company, and they also have special works created for them, all to enhance their experiences and to make them better artists at the end of that training period with us. And hopefully that will be prepare them better equipped to brave the new professional world they're about to face.
Yeah. Lee, you're a very good friend of the Prix de Lausanne. Last year you were here on the jury. There's many competitions now in the ballet world. Tell us what makes for you the Prix de Lausanne distinctive and unique.
I love the Prix for its nurturing and learning environment and the scholarship opportunities they offer to the participants. And they have the opportunity to work and learn from some of the world's best teachers, coaches, and choreographers. And also a lot of the directors from schools and companies come here looking for talents for their respective organizations. One of our young artists last year, Nenika Yoshida, who was also 2013 Prix finalist. And it was an incredible, exciting discovery for me to see her performing. She really touched me. So as a director, I want to have her in my company. So I'm pleased to say that she spent 1 year as a Yetta Parker Young Artist, and she's now one of our newest company member.
That's wonderful. Thank you. Thank you, Lee. Greg, let me turn to you now. Thank you. Thanks, Lee. First of all, Greg, congratulations on that lovely piece, Glass Concerto, which I think we all absolutely loved. The dancers looked marvellous in it. You are a very experienced choreographer. You've worked with a lot of companies. As a choreographer, what qualities are you looking for in a dancer?
Thank you, Deborah. I like to look for dancers that have a sensitivity for the movement that's created, musicality is important, and not only to be able to really listen to the music but interpret it as well. But most importantly, I think it's important that dancers dance from their heart and soul, really.
And working with young dancers, such as we saw you work with today, what particular qualities do they bring that's perhaps different?
Well, it can be more challenging creating works on younger, more inexperienced dancers. You have to encourage their own creativity to come through and to take responsibility and ownership for what they dance. Mm. But these dancers, they bring a great energy, enthusiasm and passion, and they truly want to improve and to become the best dancers that they can become.
And finally, Lee, I think we're almost ready to open the curtains, but let me ask you one question. You've had an incredible career as a dancer and as a director. What piece of advice would you give to these young dancers, whether they win or not?
I would say to them, never lose your love, passion, and dedication for dance, and always believing in yourself, no matter what challenges you may be facing in the future.
Brilliant. I'm sure that's fantastic advice. Thank you to you both for joining us today.
Thank you.
And now I think we are ready for the announcement of this year's winner. So let's open the curtain and give a warm round of applause to the finalists who are here on the stage. Thank you. Now, we've enjoyed watching these finalists today, but just taking part in the Prix de Lausanne is an achievement in itself. So, before we do anything else, I'm going to ask any of the candidates who came to Lausanne but were not selected, if you're here in the audience, please stand up, because we'd like to applaud you and acknowledge your achievement. So please. And for the finalists themselves. Thank you. Also joining us today on the stage, we have Amanda Bennett, the Prix's Artistic Director. And the President of the Board of Trustees, Stefan Lagonico. Now, Stefan. Stefan has a long association with the Prix, but he's only very recently become the President. So I'm intrigued to know a little bit of your reflections on the week, and what do you see as the opportunities going forward?
Certainly, Deborah. Well, on behalf of the Board, I wish to say how pleased we are with the 43rd Prix. We are impressed with the diversity of the candidates, and their level is very high. I am committed to ensuring the Prix retains its status as a world standard of quality and see all the rising stars emerge from its ranks. We are also exploring ways to develop the Prix as a resource for the dance community throughout the year.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Stefan.
Thank you, Deborah.
Thank you. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce this year's jury, who plays such a vital role in the competition. Each one is a distinguished member of the international dance community, and they generously donate their time, their skills, and their expertise to the Prix. They are the first ever Prix de Lausanne winner from 1973. She was a principal dancer in Stuttgart, the artistic director of the Deutsche Oper Berlin. She is Sylviane Bayard. Next, we have a principal dancer from Birmingham Royal Ballet, who was a Prix de Lausanne prize winner in 1994, Chi Chow. And another Prix de Lausanne winner, this time from 1988. She's a principal dancer of the Bavarian State Opera Ballet in Munich. She's Lisa Marie Cullum. And now the artistic director of the American Ballet Theatre, Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis School, Franco De Vita. The director of the Vienna State Opera Ballet Academy, Simona Neuger. The director of the ballet of the Teatro Colón in Buenos Aires, Lydia Senyi. former principal dancer of American Ballet Theatre in New York and former director of the Royal New Zealand Ballet, a Prix de Lausanne prize winner in 1989, Ethan Stiefel. The rector of the Hungarian Dance Academy, Jurgi Sarkai. And finally, the president of this year's jury, the renowned ballerina with American Ballet Theatre and the Royal Ballet in London, and now an international guest teacher, she is Cynthia Harvey. And before I ask Cynthia to say a few words, we're just going to take a moment to say thank you to our generous sponsors, whose continued support is vital to the Prix and to the future of these young dancers. So they are La Vie de Lausanne, La Fondation Lénard, Le Canton de Vaud, ADVEC Management, The Oak Foundation, La Fondation Coromandel, MCH Beaulieu Lausanne, Bobst, La Loterie Romande, Carigest SA, Le Beau Rivage Palace, Artifilia Stiftung, La Fondation Invenie, Chacot, and Harlequin. And in addition to this, we're grateful to a number of individuals and companies who continue to support the Prix, and indeed to the members of our circle of friends of the Prix de Lausanne. So now, to announce the winners, finally, I'm going to hand over to the president of the jury, Cynthia Harvey. Thank you. Thanks, Deborah.
In an art form where competitions are sometimes vilified, the Prix de Lausanne stands out. What the Prix de Lausanne offers these young people is ingress to the long corridor that will become their careers. It embraces the highest standards and provides the young students who attend with invaluable advice, instruction, and opportunity. I am honored to have presided alongside the other members of this esteemed jury, all of whom have taken their responsibilities in earnest. Thank you all. Ballet is a rule-based art form, and as such, the knowledge of a jury is tested. In addition, the requirement for dancers to perform a wide variety of movement, as shown by the contemporary choreography offered here, presents us with diversity. When it's a matter of taste, it's not entirely subjective, because we are all influenced by our surroundings. But when enough people enjoy the same perspective, a winner can be found. This is how it works here at the Prix de Lausanne. We cannot and should not quantify this art form by judgment based on how many or how much. It is distinctiveness that speaks to us and spoke to us today. In conclusion, I would like to thank all those who have participated here. When there are so many distractions today, I applaud you for your dedication. For the choreographers, teachers, and parents, we thank you for your generosity in guiding and cultivating our young in the direction of this art form. Your support and that of all the sponsors here at the Prix de Lausanne is greatly appreciated. Thank you. Our first prize today is the audience prize, 500 Swiss francs from the Fondation en faveur de l'art choreographique. And it goes to Lou Spitchtig. I hope I get it. Well done, Lou. There you go. My pleasure. Congratulations. Spitchtig. Next, we have the Best Swiss Candidate Prize, 2,500 Swiss francs, from the Fondation Leonard to Miss Lou Spitchtig. I got it right this time. I congratulate you this time first. There you go. And now the Contemporary Dance Prize, an all-inclusive internship from the Minerva Kunststiftung. Miguel Pinheiro. My rehearsal was better than my performance. Thank you. And we move on now to the Prix de Lausanne scholarships. And remember that any of the finalists who do not win a scholarship today receive a consolation prize generously donated by Bobst. My rehearsal was better than my performance, always. Scholarship number 6, offered by Harlequin Floors, goes to Julian McKay. There you go. Scholarship number 5, offered by the Fondation Coromandel, goes to Rina Kanehara. Congratulations, dear. Here you go. Well done. Scholarship number 4, offered by the Oak Foundation, goes to Miguel Pinheiro. Once again, congratulations. There you go. Scholarship number 3, offered by ADVEC, goes to Mitsuro Ito. Congratulations, pleasure. There you go. Scholarship number 2, offered by the Beau Rivage Palace, goes to Jisoo Park. We're here now, right? Scholarship number 1, offered by the Fondation Leonard, goes to Harrison Lee. Congratulations, Lee. Well done. Harrison, you have to get one of these as well. Well done. Congratulations to all our winners.
And that is it for 2015. Congratulations to these talented young dancers and indeed to all our winners this year. Now, do please remember to check our website in 1 month's time to find out which schools and companies these dancers have chosen. Before we go, a big thank you from everyone to the staff here at the Théâtre de Beaulieu, a big thank you to the Prix de Lausanne office staff, to Dr. Carlo Baguti, and to the many volunteers who give their time, not only this week, but throughout the year. And of course, thank you to all of you for coming. Do put a date in your diary, February the 6th, 2016, for the 44th Prix de Lausanne. Now, before we go, I'm just going to have a few words with our winner. This is for you. So, I've got two questions. You're taking home a medal and a scholarship, and congratulations. What else are you taking away from the Prix de Lausanne?
I'm taking away a week's worth of experience with such great classes and teachers. I'm taking away some amazing friendships that have really strengthened over the week, and yeah, that's it.
And finally, we're going live on the web. We've had, I think, 3 million YouTube views this week, so somebody's seen you, I'm sure. I suspect you might have some friends and family watching at home. Would you like to say anything to them?
I'd just like to say hello to my little sister and grandma and all my family and friends watching back home and my ballet teachers. Thank you all so much for your support and belief in me. I really couldn't be here without you guys, so thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. So, I think we should let these dancers get on and enjoy a very special evening. I hope you've enjoyed the performance. Thank you for being with us. Keep an eye out for all these talented young dancers in the years to come. Thank you for your support of the Prix de Lausanne. From all of us, thank you for watching and goodbye.